Say you ever wanna see a f***ed up Japanese version of Gigolo Joe from AI Artificial Intelligence wherein he's thrown out by his owners for not getting it up? Boy, have I got a movie for you. After diving back into the Japanese pinky violence genre with Honda Turkish Bathhouse, I decided to try out a little more variations of Japanese exploitation. And of course, I began with the classic 964 Pinocchio, aka Screams of Blasphemy, from 1991. Yes, this is... I am recording this the same time that I'm recording the Honda Turkish Bathhouse video. I'm trying to multitask, I'm being professional. Taking a couple cues from the recent popularity of Shinya Tsukamoto's Tetsuo the Iron Man, this is a wild and kinetic detour into the underbelly of a vaguely cyberpunk Tokyo. The titular sex robot is taken in by a homeless girl whose memory has been wiped, and, well, lots of stuff happens, that's for sure. Not sure how much of it I can actually really describe, but... it happens. There's vomiting. By the by, while the Tetsuo connection never verges into ripoff territory, this is very much its own thing. The similarities aren't terribly surprising. Not only is the timing right, as Tetsuo was released and widely acclaimed back in 1988, but 964 Pinocchio director Shozen Fukui? Ah, God, I really should have checked this. Shozi was the assistant director on Tetsuo. That Tokyo. Small town. Aside from the genre and time period, as well as just being politically incorrect in all the best ways, one big similarity is the camera work. While Pinocchio features a more diverse color palette, it has an energetic, handheld, anarchic feel and penchant for extreme close-ups with wide-angled lenses, which, if I'm being honest enough to negate my own point, was super popular in this low-budget Japanese sci-fi indie scene of that time. Just look at the V-cinema craze. It was everywhere. They love their wide angles. So do I. Love you guys. Love this wide. Look at my arms. They're so freakishly long. Now, like Tetsuo, this film is also hella fucked up. It does take a little while to get there with lots of character building for our two leads in the first half hour or so, but once our mentally disadvantaged protagonist goes haywire at around 34-odd minutes in, looking like he can't decide between ketchup and mustard, man, things get fucking off the proverbial chain.
Wah, wah, wah.
It's a lot of fun. I love the sound design in this film. There's a great scene of guerrilla filmmaking when our homeless heroine freaks out in the subway, and as she's walking through a hall with her arms flailing in circles, it syncs up to the sound of a train, which that's just gold right there. That's, you know, wah. Also, the whole sequence gives strong possession vibes, and I'm all about that life. I really can't emphasize enough in these videos how important good sound is, be it the actual recording of dialogue, music, Foley effects, that old saying about sound being 90% of the image or whatever the fuck, it's true. And between the industrial soundtrack and gnarly sound effects of 964 Pinocchio, we get a soundscape that, while not perfect, does add a film of dirt to the image that really ramps up the gross proceedings. And since we keep coming back to low-budget filmmaking in these reviews, I'd like to suggest all of you aspiring indie kids indulge yourselves in these Japanese midnight movies. They give you a good idea of what can be done with fairly little, and how if you don't have the necessities for a stable image, you can simply go the opposite way and let chaos reign, baby. Be it this film, Tetsuo, or any number of esoteric underground nonsense with little money and big balls, it's all very inspirational and further proves you don't need high-end tech to make high-end thrills, people. While there's very little in the way of traditionally beautiful cinematography, Antoine Fuqua's smart enough to have developed a film that doesn't require any of that bullshit. Lighting is minimal throughout, while movement and extreme angles push a constant bolt of energy through the spastic body of this film, which is also a very silly comedy. Now here's a great example of chaos wisely replacing the mundane. This guy just found out something really important for his boss. He's desperate to contact him, so he runs to a payphone. Now, the easy way to do this would be to just smash cut to him on the phone. See? Works fine. Now, that's not how Shozen whatever the fuck rolls, yo. Instead, we get this. Fucker bust out the Snorri cam for a telephone call. Is it totally necessary? Not for the story, but for the vibes and to get across that character's fucking moment? Hell yeah! Oh, I'm being so excited about this. Ah, It's the weed. It's the weed. But hey, for y'all kids, what just like looking at what the fuck are y'all on screen, bodily fluids abound, man and machine become one, and things are generally messed up in 964 Pinocchio, making it a pretty mandatory watch. A pretty mandatory watch for the fans of psychotronic cinema. If I had one big negative, it's that the film is, it's a smidge too long. Just a sconch. It's a sconch too long. This is about 80 minutes at the most, stretched out to 97, and despite the breakneck editing approach, there are times when it wears out its welcome. But that's really it. I guess I would have liked a little more world building and exploration of Pinocchio's plight, but that's asking the movie to cross its own stylistic boundaries a bit, so whatever. Otherwise, totally made for me. Unfortunately, it is out of print. Hey guys, naked editor Michael here. I wrote this script in like January, and it turns out that Media Blasters put out a new Blu-ray of Pinocchio, so I am mistaken. The unearthed Blu-ray is still out of print, but to be fair, it is available on Blu-ray. So, go buy that from Diabolic DVD. Not a sponsor, but cool nonetheless. Could still use a Fukui collection. Having previously been released on DVD by Unearthed Films in 2007. So hopefully we get a Blu-ray collection of Shozen fucks work. It's not a particularly large filmography, but it is one I would love to add to my shelves. Literally like right there. That's where the Unearthed stuff is. It's right there. So go right there. If it was Unearthed. Vinegar Syndrome. Well, Vinegar Syndrome. If Severn put it out, if Severn got into the Japanese game. Otherwise, it's going to the living room. What the fuck am I talking about? Go watch a movie. You fucking sicko.
Sate, 964 の回収方法についてなのですが。
ああ、あれな。果たして。
Such lazy bitch. Bum bum bum. This is now time traveling weed.